Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Morning. Today we celebrate Passion Sunday, and so let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so that by following your holy will we may gain eternal salvation. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the first form of the Confiteor found on page 66. Almighty Father, you know my deepest secrets. I confess that I have, through my own fault, sinned against your holy laws in my thoughts, in my words, and what I have done or failed to do. I sincerely regret my sins, and I am truly sorry for offending you. I ask, Father, that in your mercy you pardon my sins. I promise to change my way of living so that through a deeper holiness I may better serve you throughout the rest of my life. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say one Our Father and one Hail Mary. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake. Some shall live forever, others shall be in everlasting horror and disgrace. Lord, for us your wounds were suffered. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, your Son has made the grave holy and a place of hope for your people. May we who die in him also rise in him. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, O my people, I will open your graves and have you rise from them and bring you back to the land of Israel. Then you shall know that I am the Lord, when I open your graves and have you rise from them, O my people. I will put my spirit in you that you may live, and I will settle you upon your land. Thus shall you know that I am the Lord. I have promised, and I will do it, says the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to my voice in supplication.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
If you, O Lord, mark iniquities, Lord, who can stand? But with you is forgiveness, that you may be revered.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
I trust in the Lord, my soul trusts in his word. More than sentinels wait for the dawn, let Israel wait for the Lord.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
For the Lord is kindness, and with him is plenteous redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all their iniquities.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
The second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are in the flesh cannot please God, but you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is alive because of righteousness. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give you life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit dwelling in you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will never die.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Now a man was ill, Lazarus from Bethany, in the village of Mary and her sister Martha. Mary was the one who had anointed the Lord with perfumed oil and dried his feet with her hair. It was her brother Lazarus who was ill. So the sisters sent word to Jesus saying, Master, the one you love is ill. When Jesus heard this, he said, this illness is not to end in death, but is for the glory of God, that the Son of God may be glorified through it. Now, Jesus loved Martha and her sister Lazarus. So when he heard that he was ill, he remained for 2 days in the place where he was. Then, after this, he said to his disciples, let's go back to Judea. The disciples said to him, Rabbi, the Jews were just trying to stone you, and you want to go back there? Jesus answered, are there not 12 hours in a day? If one walks during the day, he does not stumble, because he sees the light of this world. But if one walks at night, he stumbles, because the light is not in him. He said this, and then told them, our friend Lazarus is asleep, but I am going to awaken him. So the disciples said to him, Master, if he is asleep, he will be saved. But Jesus was talking about his death, while they thought he meant ordinary sleep. So then Jesus said to them clearly, Lazarus has died, and I am glad for you that I was not there, that you may believe. Let us go to him. So Thomas, called Didymus, said to his fellow disciples, let us also go to die with him. When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away. And many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about her brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. Jesus said to her, Your brother will rise. Martha said to him, I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus told her, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? She said to him, Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world. When he had said this, she went and called her sister Mary secretly, saying, The teacher is here and is asking for you. As soon as she heard this, she rose quickly and went to him. For Jesus had not yet come into the village, but was still where Martha had met him. So when the Jews who were with her in the house comforting her saw Mary get up quickly and go out, they followed her, presuming that she was going to the tomb to weep there. When Mary came to where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said to him, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. When Jesus saw her weeping and the Jews who had come with her weeping, he became perturbed and deeply troubled and said, Where have you laid him? They said to him, Sir, come and see. And Jesus wept. So the Jews said, See how he loved him. But some of them said, Could not the one who opened the eyes of the blind man have done something so that this man would not have died? So Jesus, perturbed again, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone lay across it. Jesus said, Take away the stone. Martha, the dead man's sister, said to him, Lord, by now there will be a stench. He has been dead for 4 days. Jesus said to her, Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? So they took away the stone. And Jesus raised his eyes and said, Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always hear me, but because of the crowd here, I have said this, that they may believe that you sent me. And when he had said this, he cried out in a loud voice, Lazarus, come out. The dead man came out, tied hand and foot with burial bands, and his face was wrapped in a cloth. So Jesus said to them, Untie him and let him go. Now many of the Jews who had come to Mary and seen what he had done began to believe in him. This is the gospel of the Lord. Taken from today's gospel according to St. John, in the name of the Father, and the Son, of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, in this rather lengthy gospel today, not as long as next week's Passion, but rather lengthy, we have the story of Lazarus, and Lazarus being raised from the dead, more specifically. There's a lot here. Firstly, the way that Lazarus was laid in the tomb with the stone rolled in front, I think is very reminiscent of what we hear about Jesus after he was laid in the tomb. And the way Jesus rose Lazarus from the dead is very reminiscent
of Jesus rising from the tomb. So this is kind of a prefigurement to that. But also, encased in this particular passage is the shortest verse in the Gospels, and Jesus wept. I think that says a lot about who he is. Because he knew what he was going to do for Lazarus. But coming upon the tomb and seeing his friend physically dead moved him to the point where he wept. But then he rose him from the dead. And raising from the dead is not just a physical thing. Jesus raises people from the dead even to this day, spiritually. How many people have we known who have just been spiritually dead, but then something touched them? Maybe someone said something to them about Christ or something, and they woke up. That was Jesus raising them from spiritual death. Maybe it happened in our own lives. I've seen it happen when I was working, especially in the prisons in Boston and Detroit, where you'd be talking to someone, and they just, you could see that there was just, they were gone. And then suddenly, something would strike them. Jesus would strike their heart. And then, in subsequent visits, you could tell that they were growing more and more alive. That's what Jesus does for us, my brothers and sisters. Not only in his word, which we know that the word of God as a sacrament will inspire us, but also in his body, blood, soul, and divinity we receive at every Mass in the Eucharist. Jesus wants us to be alive in him. And if we live here on this world, we will live with him forever in the next. But if we die to him in this world, we will be dead in the next. So in these waning weeks of Lent, perhaps we can reflect on the ways, firstly, in our lives, that we may have been spiritually dead and need to reinvigorate with a little bit more Jesus inside of us, but also helping those whom we love, who we know, maybe come to know Jesus in a little bit different way and give them that life. Because what better gift can we give someone else than life in Christ? And Jesus wept. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. The third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Confident that our destiny is to return to God, we place our petitions before him. Our response is, Lord, have mercy.
Prime Bishop Anthony, Bishop Jerry, and all clergy, that the life of the Spirit may strengthen and guide them as they minister to God's people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace and hope, especially in Ukraine and other countries afflicted by war, violence, and poverty, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For families, that our homes will be a place of prayer, generosity, forgiveness, and unconditional love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick and the suffering, especially those on the parish prayer list, that they may not feel abandoned, but know that the Lord is powerfully present to them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the special intentions we hold deep in the silence of our hearts. And for Reverend Czeslaw Locke, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died believing in the resurrection, and those who will die today, that they may share the joy of eternal life in Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. God, our Father, we thank you for the gift of the Spirit who gives us life. Hear and answer our prayers according to your holy will. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed and holy is the one who shares in the first resurrection. The second death has no power over these. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, to you, who has spread off what truth is given, human hands of may become for us the bread of life. Mystery of this wine. And water, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness, wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless this sacrifice which we have prepared for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, Most Holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they, whose memory we honor on earth, intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Almighty, ever-living God, receive this offering and lead our hearts back to you. Through the merits of this spotless sacrifice, may we receive the promise of eternal inheritance. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the
Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The suffering and death of your Son brought life to the whole world, moving our hearts to praise your glory. The power of the cross reveals your judgment on this world and the kingship of Christ crucified. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy Sacrifice of the Mass will continue with Eucharistic Prayer 1, which is found on page 77. Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, we ask you to accept and bless these gifts we offer you in sacrifice. We offer them for your Holy Catholic Church, asking you to defend and guide it throughout the world. We offer them for Anthony, our Prime Bishop, and Jerry, our Bishop, and for all bishops, priests, deacons, and other ministers who profess the true faith which comes to us from the apostles. Remember, Lord, your people, especially our brothers and sisters, for whom we now pray. Remember all of us who are present here, who truly believe and are devoted to you. We offer the sacrifice of praise to you, our living, eternal, and true God, for ourselves and all those we love, for the redemption of our souls, and with hope for our salvation. Together with the whole church, we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary, the mother of our Lord Jesus Christ. We also honor the apostles and martyrs, as well as all those who have lived and died confessing your name. In remembering them, we desire to follow their example and so gain your love and help. Father, accept this offering from your whole family. Grant us your peace in this life. Preserve us from spiritual damnation and count us among your chosen people. Bless, accept, and approve this offering we now make to you and let it be pleasing to you. Fill it with the power of your Holy Spirit and let it become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The day before he suffered and died, our Lord desired to make his love known to his disciples and all who would follow him. He therefore instituted these sacred mysteries by which he joined himself with them spiritually and bodily in his whole being and abides with us forever. At that moment, so sacred for all of humanity, Jesus took bread into his holy hands and looking up to heaven to you, his almighty Father, he gave thanks. He blessed the bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." Supper had ended, he took the cup in the same way he gave you thanks and blessed it, giving it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." Father, in celebration of the memory of Jesus Christ, your Son, we, your people, recall his passion, resurrection from the dead, and ascension into glory. From the many gifts you have given us, we offer you this pure, holy, and spotless offering, the holy bread of life and the holy cup of eternal salvation. Look favorably on these offerings and accept them as you once accepted the gifts of your servant Abel and the sacrifice of our father in faith Abraham and the bread and wine offered by your priest Melchizedek. In humility, we ask, Father, that these offerings be carried by your angel to your high altar in heaven, so that we who receive the sacred body and blood of your Son from this altar may be filled with your grace and blessing. Remember, Lord, our brothers and sisters who have died and have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, especially Father Cheslov and all of our family and friends who have passed. May these and all who rest in Christ find happiness, light, and peace. And we who trust in your love also ask to be included in the fellowship of your holy apostles, martyrs, and saints who offered their lives to you. They were filled with your justice and mercy, and because they lived in accord with the teachings of Jesus, gained eternal joy. Count us among them, Father, not because of what we truly deserve, but because you are willing to forgive us. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, by whom you give us all these gifts. You fill them with life and goodness. You bless them and make them holy. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Page 95, let us now pray together with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Let's say together the First Communion prayer on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching, and never let me be parted from you. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. For those who, for personal reasons, cannot receive the body and blood of Christ today, and those who are following us online, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. Behold, this is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Thank you. body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ.
Amen.
Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line with all the other not quite, with all the never get it right. But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time. 'Cause I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
When Moses had stage fright and David brought a rock to a sword fight, you picked 12 outsiders nobody would have chosen, and you changed the world. Well, the moral of the story is everybody's got a purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. For the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
So let me go down, down, down in history as another blood-bought, faithful member of the family. And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. So let me go down, down, down in history.
Down in history.
As another blood-bought, faithful member of the family.
That's all I ever wanna be.
And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
Just a nobody,
nobody
trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. Living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
Nobody but Jesus.
But your dead shall live, their corpses shall rise. Awake and sing, you who lie in the dust. Let us pray. Lord of life and death, you have redeemed us with the precious blood of your Son. Through this Eucharist we have received, keep us firm in the confession of his name, so that we may gain eternal life as he promised. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Let us bless the Lord. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for our Holy Mass today. And you may have noticed in the last few weeks we have added the lyrics to the songs into the bulletin, and I'd just like to invite you, especially as we go out today, to sing together in the full voice. The final song piece is Flowing Like a River. Again, the words are included. Hope you have a wonderful day. Stay safe. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. Remain in a state of grace. Fight evil wherever you find it, and spread joy wherever you go.